it's me, Timmy Flyersguy. I'm going to do something a little different on Classic Flyers Theater. So I'm premiering in this episode of Classic Flyers Theater. I'm going to call this Classic Flyers Theater Shorts. And these will be some quick videos of some of my favorite clips from Flyers games. So in today's first episode of Classic Flyers Theater Shorts, we're going to take a look back at a game between the Philadelphia Flyers and the Washington Capitals, where all hell broke loose in the third period. So I hope you enjoy this first episode of Classic Flyers Theater Shorts.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm going to call this the night when the Philadelphia Flyers had enough. I hope you enjoy this.
NHL games. The guy was signed to a pretty hefty contract, and now he's got warming, or I should say, another cavalry run at by Simmons, and Simmons will drop the gloves to Tom Wilson, who can really throw them. And now Ray Emery's racing the length of the ice. Ray Emery is challenging Holtby. Holtby's saying, no, I don't think I want to go. And the referee's going to try to keep them separated, and he won't be able to do that as away they go. Emery with the right hand's free, and he's hammering away on Holtby. Capitals not coming to his aid at this point as Emery is just having his way with Holtby.
While this has been going on, there's been a lot of talk going back and forth, and anything but friendly.
Oh, we got another one going now as LeCavalier is trading with Alexi, and now Shen going at it as well with Urbom, and it's a line brawl for sure here at Wells Fargo Center. Just about everybody tangled up right here. Shen goes down as Urbom winds up on top of that scuffle. A lot of frustration.
This is frustration. Yeah, absolutely, Jimmy. And you know what? This is a calling card. This is saying, okay, guys, all right, we're getting waxed right now in the score. But hey, don't leave anything on the ice. Go home and don't understand that you're going to come back tomorrow with a little fire. This is the fire the Flyers have been looking for.
Ray Emery knew exactly what he wanted to do, and John Carlson's losing his mind now because he doesn't think the referee helped Holtby enough, as the ref was there trying to stop the fight, but just one referee there and two bodies. And Ray Emery put a beating on Braden Holtby, who heads over to the athletic trainer of the Capitals, and the referees talk as they try to sort this out.
Oh, they're going to have a tough time with this one. It all started with Simmons and Wilson, because Wilson had been really gabby with the Washington Capitals, been going at it with Hartnell all night to my left. And then all of a sudden, Simmons knew, because Simmons had been pretty aggressive too throughout this evening as far as the narration. Let's go once again and take a look how this all started.
Well, Wayne Simmons was aggressive. Make his first target right there as he ran over Alexi, and then he went after Wilson. Wilson quickly dropping the gloves, and Simmons really held his own against a guy who's known as quite a fighter, Tom Wilson. And while this is happening, Emery is making a dash for Holtby, who wanted nothing to do with him at first. And then finally they go as one referee, Francois Saint-Laurent just could not keep them apart.
Yeah, and Emery just kept going and kept throwing punches. And Holtby tried to get up and react, and then two more fights broke out while that was going on. Braden Shen dropped his gloves with Urbom. Knocked the helmet off first, and a couple of rights going back and forth between those two guys and Vinny LeCavalier at the same time fighting Oleski, who's a real tough kid. And Vinny held his own in that department.
Well, every one of those were good ones. But Emery, remember when Emery first was a draft pick of the Ottawa Senators, he had come up. Everybody knew that one thing he could do on top of playing net was he could really throw them. Any questions here? Right here, you can tell.
He's had some boxing training, and, you know, hope he is trying to protect himself in any way he can.
It was the fight when he was with Ottawa against the Buffalo Sabres. Was it Marty Biron that he ended up fighting in that game?
It was. He
and the heavyweight Peters. Also, he fought the heavyweight of the Buffalo Sabres that night.
Peters got involved, yeah. There are the penalties.
I was not great in math, so I'm going to have troubles with that one.
Well,
Coatsy, it's all yours. Figure that out for us.
Well, just go right down the side. Obviously, Simmons and Wilson are going to go. You got Shen and Urban. LeCavier, Oleski. I would imagine everybody will just get 5 and 10 get thrown right out of here. Let's see who's in the box over there. We got Simmons still in the box.
Well, we can see right there Wilson's in the box.
Emery will get leaving the crease as you see Steve Mason back.
That's right. Simmons is gone now. Emery's gone. Mason back in.
And right now, Saint-Laurent telling Claude Giroux about the penalties. Who know him will tell the rest of us momentarily. It may take him a while.
Yep. Holtby appears to be fine. He'll stay in goal.
Flyers number 40, Vincenzo Cavalier, 5 minutes for fighting, plus a game misconduct each for secondary fight. Washington penalty number 34, Alexander Urban. Flyers penalty number 10, Braden Shen, each 5 minutes for fighting, each game misconduct, secondary fight. Number 24, Washington, Aaron Volpatti, a 10-minute misconduct. For Washington, number 70, Braden Holtby, goalkeeper, 5 minutes for fighting. For the Flyers, number 29, goalkeeper Ray Emery, 2 minutes for leaving the crease, 2 minutes for instigation, 5 minutes for fighting, a 10-minute misconduct, plus a game misconduct. Penalties come in 5 minutes,
there you go.
31 seconds.
And the two minors on Emery, the only difference in the penalty calls, in addition to, of course, his misconduct, but as far as affecting manpower, it's a 4-minute power play for the Capitals as we get back to action. And the league will look at that situation as well.
They will.
No question about it, they'll review that. Just make sure everything was okay with it. Emery did leave his crease. There's no question what he was trying to do there. Here's Raffle cutting it on goal. The backhander and the save made by Holtby.
Well, that was a nice shot. He had nowhere to go. He was stuck right there on the backhand because Green was on the other side of him. He was looking upstairs, but just didn't get enough on it.
You got to give Holtby some credit because he just got pounded in a fight.
Yeah.
Gets right back in there, faces a partial breakaway, and takes care of it.
Yep, good concentration on his part. You have to like what Ray Emery did there to try to get something from his teammates in front of him.
Well, as we mentioned, Steve Mason now back in the game, having a little trouble handling the puck there. Frank Berube tried everything he could to get this thing turned around. Ray Emery figured out, best thing I can do at this point. And he took off. Carlson down low, the shot up by Mason, the save. So he was able to get that one. Now Carlson from the point. That one snared by Emery. He'll hang on to it. Schmidt down low that first opportunity.
You can reserve a suite for an upcoming Flyers game through November and choose a free suite for the return of Disney on ice this holiday season or from one of two Phantoms games this February. Lock your Wells Fargo Center suites in now.
Well, Simmons, you could tell, was right on a mission, wasn't he? Right off that face-off, bang. Then he ends up with Wilson, who happens to be a little bit bigger at 6'4". Did a heck of a job with him, and Emery just jumped right on the opportunity and skated the 200 feet.
Yeah, we should point out, Simmons had the same tactics. Ray Emery was trying to do something there. Just frustration, yes. That puck deflects into the blue paint, and Mason covers, but clearly just tried to say, boys, we can't just take this one without showing some kind of fight.
Yep.
And so he ended up in a But with a guy who can really drop the gloves and go in Tom Wilson, and Simmons did win that fight. There's Backstrom.